I'm Lieven Vandegaer from MEDIAGENIX, and I will be talking about how we are using Camunda for orchestrating a video on demand pipeline using WHATS'ON, Camunda BPM, and Apache NiFi. So I will first talk a little bit about the company and what we do, then about actual workflow, and then about what we learned using Camunda. So a little bit about the company. So we work for MEDIAGENIX. MEDIAGENIX is a company that exists for 20 years, provides solutions for media companies. So we have one solution, one product, which is called WHATS'ON. And with WHATS'ON, we manage the whole workflow, but not as in a Camunda workflow, the whole workflow of broadcasters. So going from rights, so capturing all of the rights for the content that they have bought, managing all of the metadata about their material, and then most important, scheduling on the linear and non-linear platforms, and then going to the actual exports to systems that will play out the video file so that you can see it on TV. So we have around 80 customers all over the world. So it's going from smaller customers to bigger customers like public broadcasters in Europe, but also including bigger groups like Disney, Viacom, Discovery, BBC, and so on. So we, with our product, we only touch typically the metadata. So it's all about metadata and users entering metadata and scheduling content on the different platforms. A bit on the technical side, so it's already an old company, or an older company. So we're WHATS'ON is written in Smalltalk, because initially it was a spin-off of a university, the Brussels University. We still love very much developing in Smalltalk, because we can do really fancy things in Smalltalk, and it goes really fast to implement new functionality. We also use an Oracle database, so the structure is very easy. We have a big monolith written in Smalltalk that talks to the Oracle database. So that's where we are. And then recently we had a new project coming on, and it was a little bit out of our comfort zone. So it was for a telecom operator or a platform owner, and the idea was to do VOD delivery. So what happens is that all of the different content providers, like the public broadcaster, for example, or commercial broadcasters, they deliver video files, XML files, images to this platform owner, and the platform owner needs to take all of these and drive transcodings, so to transcode it in the right format for the VOD backend, to do encryption, to communicate with the VOD backends. So that was a little bit out of our comfort zone. We, for example, had in the product a workflow engine, but we immediately saw that it was not suitable to use in this kind of setup. It's also involving lots of file transfers, which we can do, but not in a way that was expected from this telecom operator. So we were really looking at, or taking the opportunity to look for a new workflow engine that could do all of, or that could help us doing all of that. Another thing that was very important is that the telecom operator was very much focused also over failover, redundancy, scalability in a much higher way than we are used to handle. So we started looking around and different workflow engines, different possible solutions, and we met Camunda. So what we did was an on-site workshop, a POC, with Benjamin Hoffman, and that was really, really helpful. So what was the result of this on-site workshop and POC? That was, we had identified three different workflows that we want to implement, so we had really the foundation of the different workflows. We figured out that it would be best to implement everything using external tasks in Camunda, because we are a Smalltalk company, so we don't have any or limited Java experience, and the idea was to have everything connected via REST APIs. For the moment, we also use the community edition, so the open source edition. So we thought, okay, that would be the plan, and then we would create all of the different workers or microservices. So some of the workers would be written in Smalltalk because they would, for example, interface or product or WHATS'ON product to, for example, update statuses, because the information comes in, is imported in our metadata system, and in the metadata system, everybody needs an up-to-date status information about all of the different concepts. We also written all the Smalltalk workers to communicate with the encryption software of the customer, transcoding software. Also the VOD backend system integration was done in our own Smalltalk services just because we were used to it, used to do it. And that worked really well. So we've just fetched and logged the tasks from the engine and then fail or complete them. Then because we were not that familiar with a lot of file transfers, we used another product, Apache NiFi. So we are also building Apache NiFi workers for everything that is related to file handling. So Apache NiFi is a system that was originally created by the NSA and is now open sourced. And it's a tool to model data flows. So you can easily model a flow. I will show an example of a flow. But in this flow, it's also possible to fetch and log the tasks, to execute the actual work, to transfer files or to put them on an FTP file, to delete them, and then again report to Camunda to either complete them or fail them. So this Apache NiFi also worked really well in combination with Camunda. So what we did is we defined these are kind of microservices within Apache NiFi. So each flow does a specific thing, for example, moves a file or puts a file on FTP. You can just start and stop them from here. You can inspect them. It's really very flexible and it works very well together. So if you go in more detail, then these building blocks, you can create them, you can connect them. On the top, you fetch the tasks. Here you fetch a file, you put it on FTP, and then the lower part would be to complete the task within WHATS'ON, so that works really well. A little bit about our workflow, a bit more detailed. So what we basically do is we have one lane here for the video files. So for each video file that comes in, we do certain things. And for each image, we do certain things. For example, the blue boxes are handled by the WHATS'ON workers, and the purple boxes are handled by the NiFi workers. So at each moment, you have a good overview of what is happening. What we really liked also is the multi-instance. So this block, this whole block, for example, is multi-instance, so it means that if it would be one video file or two video files or 10 video files, it doesn't matter. It's automatically handled also for if you transfer it to an FTP, if it's one or 10, it doesn't matter. So that's really very flexible. We also very much like the handling of the priority. So each, when an asset comes in, it gets a certain priority depending on from which content provider it gets. And this priority is then handled also by Camunda, so each external task has its own priority, and based on the priority, the workers will treat it first, earlier or later. Also, handling of errors and incidents is really very helpful. Within the workflow, we only use basic JavaScript, because again, we don't have a lot of Java experience, but the basic JavaScript allows us just enough to design the flows and to make the connections. We also use a lot of the input and output variables. So each task, if it gets fetched, it will get its own output variable. So each worker will get, for example, if it needs to update the status, it will get the variable about which object it needs to update, to which status it needs to be updated, and so on. And it's all external tasks, so there are no other type of tasks. Another thing that actually came up during the project was, for example, to have a timer. So we wait at a certain moment here. We wait till the license of the asset arrives. So they could already ingest something that should go live in 3 weeks, for example, and then it will actually wait within the workflow till the time arrives when it can continue to the flow. So we will have a lot of long-running workflows. Also, the signals were very handy. And that's just not because of the signals, but the workflow gave us the flexibility that that we really needed during the project, that things popped up and solved them within the workflow. So what we learned, we learned a lot of good things. So it matches very well to the expectations of the telecom operator about being fully redundant. So we have two Camunda instances running at all times, three NiFi servers, and so on. So it's very, it helped us a lot to reach these needs of the customer. It's also very flexible. So like I said, one image or 10 images, it doesn't matter. If, for example, we built one worker within WHATS'ON to resize an image, now we actually see that maybe it's a better idea to do it via NiFi or via another technology, then it's very easy to, even if it would be in production, to just stop the worker and to replace it by another worker. So that's very flexible. So it's also scalable because the amount of workers can be extended. What we also learned is a little bit of pains with the microservices. So because you have, of course, all these services now running, we used to have within WHATS'ON, it's one monolith. So there is typically not so much to monitor, but now we have suddenly 20 different services that we need to monitor, that we need to log, and so on. So handling that is still something that we must improve on. Also communication between the different services, and mainly also regarding security, how do you make sure that WHATS'ON can communicate securely with Camunda and Camunda with NiFi. The workflow diagram itself, it's very, very good that it can be so easily deployed. So if there is a new workflow, we can really easily deploy it without stopping the whole process. Testing is still a bit painful. So we have a lot of automatic tests for our WHATS'ON that is running already. But we now are adding also tests for Camunda, but testing these flows is not always, so the automated testing is not as good as it could be. The bridging is also not so easy. So if you write some, if you do some modifications to the workflow and we test whether it's okay, then we, because it's maybe at the end of the workflow, we have to step through the whole workflow just to find out that, okay, we might make a typo. So the bridging is not always as flexible as we are used to in our WHATS'ON project. It also has, for us, but that's not really related to Camunda maybe, but a big organizational impact, because we are now using these different technologies that we were not used to. So also regarding customer support, regarding maybe new projects where we want to use the same, we have to involve people and learn them the new way of doing things in this project. So that's also organizational, that puts a lot of not problems but challenges. So how do we feel right now? So right now is also a very important week for us, because the project will go live end of this week. So we are very happy to have done the step to go from our normal way of working to using Camunda, using NiFi and the WHATS'ON services, but it's not live yet, so we expect maybe some tough days still to come up, and then it will really prove how good it will be or how robust it will be, but we're very confident that it will work out well. And overall, we're very, very glad that we taken the step to use Camunda. So that's it. Any questions?
How did you connect the NiFi workers to Camunda?
In NiFi, we created a data flow that does a REST call. So it does a REST call to Camunda to fetch the tasks that are open for example, transfer to an FTP, and then we process the result of that, and then we parse out the important information, and based on that we can do the transfer. Okay, thank you.